Apptronik reveals the world's first general-purpose humanoid robot Apollo, which will be a useful bipedal robotics platform that can be built upon with more AI and robotics apps, much like how Apple's iPhone provided a general-purpose mobile device that also enabled further app development. Apptronik, located in Austin, Texas, is the latest firm to attempt to create a practical general-purpose robot, and it aims to prioritize cost and reliability from the beginning. For instance, by designing its own actuators in a cost-effective and supply-chain-friendly manner. Their goal is to develop this humanoid robotics platform for a cost of less than $100,000, with the aim of delivering 1 million robots by 2030, and they plan on showcasing the alpha prototype this year at SXSW in March. Given the current state of commercial humanoid robots, the breakthrough angle of the Apollo is the company's intention to provide the robot as the first-ever full-stack framework for robotics and artificial intelligence developers to build additional apps. This will allow the robot to carry out even more tasks over time, in turn helping to scale the Apollo by increasing its overall versatility. Shockingly, this would also create a multi-billion dollar downstream market for independent artificial intelligence and robotics developers, just like the iPhone did for mobile app developers. Apptronik's Apollo stands at 1.75 meters tall, weighs 75 kilograms, and is capable of lifting 25 kilograms. Apollo can operate wirelessly both indoors and outdoors, with Apptronik's aim being to offer a high-performance, user-friendly, and multifunctional robot, like an iPhone of robots, to serve as a hardware platform for independent software developers to work with. From the time of the robot's commercial release, the company intends to make sure Apollo can perform essential tasks, including movement and manipulation, thus ensuring its core value to achieve large-scale adoption and cost efficiency. While Apptronik's vision for their new Apollo humanoid robot is full autonomy, in the near to intermediate future, they plan to implement a hybrid autonomy system with a human operator overseeing and providing manual control when necessary through teleoperation. Apptronik plans to use mass production methods to create the Apollo as a highly flexible robot that is as affordable as current industrial robots. Furthermore, the company is eliminating the use of expensive or exclusive components to avoid supply chain problems and meet their desired price goal for the robot. In addition to the Apollo robot, Apptronik also built the Astra humanoid robot for space research, but the company's new focus for the Apollo is commercialization, which gives it a distinct outlook on robotics development, compared to projects like its Astra that was designed to serve organizations such as NASA in a research setting. While the Astra robot is currently conducting pilot projects with clients, mainly in logistics, Apptronik has shifted its focus internally to robots with legs. The company says their goal of creating a commercially viable product rather than complex bespoke humanoids involves prioritizing factors such as reducing component count, ensuring ease of maintenance and durability, and maintaining cost effectiveness. In order to achieve this, Apptronik says their approach involved determining the minimum necessary design for a humanoid robot, then gradually adding complexity as necessary to address specific issues. The initial goal of the Apollo is to replace humans in hazardous, unpleasant, or physically demanding work environments, as well as target supply chain and logistic tasks, plus other forms of labor that are generally undesirable for humans. The Apollo robot is slated to pose a real benefit in these areas as there is already a shortage of workers available to perform many of these kinds of tasks. While the progress in humanoid robotics research looks extremely promising, artificial intelligence research has also been leaping ahead as Meta unveils its new Make a Video 3D artificial intelligence. Meta's Make a Video 3D creates lively 3D scenes from textual descriptions, rendered in real time by 3D engines. Following text and images, generative AI models are poised to produce videos and 3D objects. Models such as Make a Video, Imagen Video, Thanaki for Video, 3DIM, Dream Fusion, or MCC all showcase potential techniques and already deliver remarkable outputs. Meta presents a combined video and 3D approach with Make a Video 3D, also known as MA3D, which is a generative AI system that creates dynamic 3D scenes from text descriptions. Google introduced Dream Fusion in September 2022, an AI model that generates 3D representations from text descriptions by using neural radiance fields. It combined neural radiance fields with the Imagen image model to generate images matching the text as its learning signals. It works by having Meta's Mav 3D follow a similar approach, using a variant called Hexplane for dynamic scenes. Hexplane produces a series of images from various camera positions, and the resulting video, along with a text prompt, is passed to Meta's video model, which evaluates the content generated by Hexplane based on the text and other factors, using the score as a learning signal for neural radiance fields, which then adjusts its parameters. Through multiple iterations, neural radiance fields learns a representation that corresponds to the text description. Mav 3D can generate 3D representations of various scenes, such as a cat singing, a panda eating ice cream, or a squirrel playing the saxophone. There is no other comparable model available at present, but Meta's results match the text prompts. Furthermore, the Hexplane model learned by Mav 3D can also be transformed into animated meshes, according to the team. The resulting scenes can then be rendered in real time by any standard 3D engine and be utilized for virtual reality or traditional video game applications. However, the process is not yet efficient, and the team is working to enhance it and increase the scene resolution. In terms of artificial intelligence progress, Mav 3D is just one example from Meta, as it has also just developed another new model called MCC, which is a technique for reconstructing a 3D model from a single image. The company envisions applications in VR, AR, and robotics. AI models leveraging transformer architectures and vast amounts of training data have resulted in impressive language models such as OpenAI's GPT-3 and ChatGPT. Advances in natural language processing have revealed that scaling often leads to foundation models that surpass previous approaches. This requires domain-agnostic architectures like transformers capable of handling various data types and self-supervised training using a large corpus of unlabeled data. The use of transformer architectures and large-scale, category-independent learning has expanded beyond language processing to areas such as image synthesis and recognition. Meta's FairLab now showcases multi-view compressive coding, a transformer-based encoder-decoder model that can reconstruct 3D objects from a single RGBD image. The researchers view MCC as a crucial step towards a generalist AI model for 3D reconstruction with potential in robotics or AR and VR applications, where better understanding and visualization of 3D spaces and objects open up numerous possibilities. Unlike other methods that require multiple images or train with hard-to-obtain 3D CAD models, Meta's approach reconstructs 3D points from readily available RGBD images. According to Meta, this makes the approach scalable and enables the creation of large datasets in the future. Meta's researchers are showcasing the potential of their MCC artificial intelligence model by training it with depth-included images and videos from diverse datasets. Tests have shown that MCC outperforms other methods, and its performance improves with more training data and diverse object categories. It can even handle new categories of objects or scenes that it hasn't seen before.